Hello guys, today I take my first look at Curvature. New updates of the software are really exciting and I cannot wait to test them out. In the upcoming weeks, I will dive deeper into new features separately. For today, let's take a look at the main features of the Curvature. First of all, there is a new name for the plugin. Now, it's called Chaos Curvature, and the logo changed. There are also some changes to the pricing and subscription terms. We can still download the trial version of the plugin. For the subscription, we can click Buy Now. Generally, we have two options. The yearly licenses are cheaper. Monthly licenses are more expensive though, in comparison to what it was before. There is still the educational version and it costs 40 euros per year. Also, the render notes are now as a separate purchase, not as before in pack with the normal subscription. Curvature 8 and later will use the same licensing implementation as Chaos, so we will gain access to all Chaos products with a single account. Where the randomization is required, we can use Chaos Scatter, which can limit trees on step slopes and curve out a roadway with splines. Let's test it quickly. So I have prepared a simple scene with a landscape model and Curvature sky. If we go to geometry panel and we choose Chaos, we'll find a Chaos Scatter there. Okay, we have different options here, but first of all, to make it work, we need to add the objects tab. Here, let's add the landscape object. And now, I will choose the trees I have prepared before. Okay, next, I will make the trees look like they grow in the natural way. So we can set the normal versus Z value to 1. Great, here we go. Now let's test the slope limitation option. First of all, we need to change it to the word. And let's start interactive rendering. Okay, we need to increase the number of trees, as it's definitely not enough of them. Better. Now let me test some different angles. I need to say that this scatter is intuitive and it works pretty well so far. I like it. Okay, I'd like to test one more option, creating roadways with splines. Here, I have the spline that I will use in the scatter. Basically, we can include or exclude splines. I will try to exclude this time, so let's add the spline here. Start interactive rendering. Here is our area. Let's set some values. Awesome! We can see that something is going on here. So we can use these values here to set the roadway we like. Awesome! Now in Curvature, similarly to in V-Ray, we have Chaos Cosmos, with a great collection of assets, materials and HDRI skies. Right-click and choose Chaos Cosmos. On the left-hand side, you can see categories. Let's start from 3D models. Let's see this one for instance. We need to download the model first. And then, if we see the green icon, we can merge it to the scene. Okay, let's see how it looks on render. Well, the materials are not too good. They look quite flat. It will be okay to use far away from the camera, but not good enough for a closer look. Apart from furniture, we can get some plants, accessories, lighting, but also 3D people. Let's see these kits for example. Okay, it looks like 3D people will work fine for the backgrounds. There are also different materials. Let me show you them quickly. So you can see that there are quite a lot of them. We can check what some flooring looks like. Let's create the sphere and apply the material. We can choose this one. Here it how it looks. Not too bad. And finally, let's see the HDRI section. Okay, there is a really nice big collection of the skies here. I like it. Let me show you how it works. We need to download the map the same way and click green icon. And it's automatically added to the scene. Awesome, isn't it? This option will definitely speed up workflow, plus it's great to have some assets on the start, especially if you don't have your own library. This option can be really helpful if you want to add some surface imperfections, like cracks on the road for instance. Really cool one. I have prepared a simple scene with boxes and spheres to test corona decals. Okay, so first of all, we need to create the corona decal object. Next, we need to apply the material we want to project. We can set the size of this manually here. And let's start interactive rendering. Okay, so we can already see the effect on the plane. We can move it around so we can understand how it works better. So basically, the map is projected in the area of the bounding box. We can exclude objects we don't want to have this effect on. You can notice now that it doesn't work on the sphere and the box. This option will make the production process way easier. We can use it, for example, to create a cross section on the road. Pretty cool and easy. We can also set the projection angle limit. So we can set angle between the surface normal and the decal that will be used. We can automatically set the option ratio of the map by using fit to assign material option. Or we can choose the bitmap to take the ratio from it. Corona slicer can be used to cut away sections of geometry at render time. It will be great if you want to create sections of buildings, for instance. Let me show you this quickly as it's pretty straightforward. We need to create an object first. I will create the box. Next, we need to look for the corona slicer material. And then apply it to the box. And that's basically it. Let's start interactive rendering to see the results. Awesome, it works pretty cool. We can move the object around to get different results. Depending on the effect we need, we can easily set it up. In the material, we have a couple of options. Cup/geometry is automatically turned on, but we can turn it off if we want. Override cup material is nice. We need to create the material we want to apply to the cupped parts of the building. I will create corona physical material. I will change the color to make it easy for you to notice it. Cool. And finally, we can exclude the parts we don't want the slicer to work with. I will exclude windows. If you need to create quick sections of some objects, this option is really nice. Here we go. You can use this option to exclude furniture inside the building, for example. By the way, all our RVs Artist courses are in Corona, so if you want to check them out, I put the link to the store in the corner. The new map in Corona gives us the possibility to add dirt or wear, resulting from how quickly the surface curves at that point. You can find this map here, like any other Corona map. I will plug it to the diffuse slot to show you how it works. Here, you can adjust the distance value. It can be very useful to quickly create material for such models without the need to create custom textures. You can make it black and white and use it as a mask. You can also use textures instead of colors. It will be so helpful and easy to isolate and adjust individual components at the post. To use it, you have to add the Cryptomatte render element. Unfortunately, you cannot use it in VFB like in V-Ray. You can only use it in applications which support Cryptomatte. Here are some options you can customize. New options have been added to the tone mapping, such as stone curve and advanced filmic mapping. Now, we have the ability to add adjustments as layers. You can add each element more than one time. You can also delete it. Additionally, we have some new options. We also have some presets, which we can customize. I will create a separate video about post-production in the Corona, so stay tuned. Additionally, there is an update that gives us an opportunity to include or exclude unwanted castings. And an adjustable PBR reflection tail in Corona physical material that is simply called base tail it lets reflection take on a softer and more distributed look with higher values. I think there are lots of new cool options in the new corona that will help to speed up the workflow and help in creating great visualizations. Let me know in the comments what do you think about new corona update and what is your favorite feature. Also, if you would like to learn how to create outstanding advanced interior visualizations, I'd like to invite you to check out our advanced interiors training. Click here to check it out on our website. Bye-bye! Thank you.